Welcome to the Photography News Show, where I talk to you about what happened in the photography industry in the past 7 days. Coming up today, we have a very interesting patent from Canon, updates about the drone from Sony, and much more. So, let's begin! Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero, travel photographer from Italy, and I want to welcome you to episode number 2 of the Photography News Show. This is a weekly series, so please consider subscribing not to miss any episode. With that being said, let's see what's new in the photography industry. Camera news. Autofocus has gotten so much better in the last few years. Cameras can now focus on the eyes of your subject very effectively, and tracking works great. So the question is, how can autofocus be improved? I would say that the major downside is having to use a button or a joystick to move the focus point. What if the camera could automatically focus where you're looking at? It's not science fiction, but it's a patent application in which Canon describes how they would build an eye control autofocus integrated into the viewfinder. Actually, if we go back to 1992, the Canon EOS 5 did have eye control autofocus, but it was not very advanced. You just had 5 focus points, and the focus would change based on which point you were looking at. Fast forward to today, and it looks like this new eye control autofocus will be implemented into the upcoming EOS R3. There is no info on how the technology will perform, but given that the R3 will be a very high-end camera, I would expect this feature to be kinda awesome and revolutionary. So, let's wait and see. In the meantime, the Technical Image Press Association has announced the winners of the TIPA World Awards 2021, which awards the best imaging products of the year. Let's now take a look at the awarded cameras in the full frame category. The Best Full Frame Camera Advanced Awards goes to the Nikon Z6 II. Best Full Frame Camera Expert, Nikon Z7 II. Last but not least, Best Full Frame Professional Camera, Sony Alpha 1. It looks like Nikon and Sony have an edge with full frame cameras, so I'm really interested in seeing how the new Canon camera will compare. Lens news. Zenit is a Russian camera brand, famous for its analog cameras and vintage lenses. Last week, they have launched 4 new full frame prime lenses for multiple mounts: the Zenit 35mm f2 and the Zenit 50mm f1.5. Both have a Sony E-mount and can be interesting to experiment with if you want to give a vintage twist to your street or portrait photography, while the other 2 new lenses have a Canon EF or Nikon F mount and are the Selina 50mm f1.9 and the Zenit 60mm f2.8 macro. All these 4 lenses should be available for purchase in the coming weeks, and I'll make sure to update the description once they do. Drone news. Back in January, Sony announced that they were working on the Airpeak, a drone intended to be used with Sony Alpha cameras. The project is still under development, and Sony is testing the drone extensively. Last month, they shared the wind resistance test, while this week, they shared the footage captured with the Airpeak in Okinawa, Japan. It's a short video that shows the drone being used in pretty challenging conditions. The cameras used for the test are the Sony FX3, which is a portable, super capable video camera, and the A7S Mark III, another incredible piece of technology. While the lens used in the test is the Sony FE 14mm f1.8 G Master. I'm really excited to see the final version of this drone, as I'm sure it will bring a lot of innovation and it will be a great addition for those that already have a Sony Alpha kit. Filter news. NiSi has released a new, very particular filter, the Circular Black Mist. It's a diffusion filter that reduces highlights and lowers contrast, with the natural consequence of softening the skin and creating a soft, pastel-like quality of light. It's designed for photographers and filmmakers that are searching for a particular look, and it's available in 3 different versions with different strength levels: 1/2, 1/4, and 1/8. I think these are great for portrait and wedding photographers, and it's something worth having in your creative toolkit. Price-wise, they go from $65 to $109. Pictures of the week. In this segment, I feature the most interesting pictures I've seen on the web. This week, we have philosopher Toby Ord that has published a project called Earth Restored, where he has digitally restored a series of NASA images taken from the Apollo voyages of the 1960s and 70s. The scans of the original pictures had very low contrast and inaccurate white balance, but thanks to his work, we can now enjoy these beautiful, renewed pictures of our planet. Weird news. The imaging world can be at times weird. This week, we have a burned and non-functioning Leica M4 from 1968 that has been sold at an auction for over 2,000 grand. Back then, the camera was around $900, but well, this one is burned, plus it comes with a Summicron 50mm, which is also burned. So at the end of the day, I think it was a great deal. Rumors. About 1 year ago, Sony released the ZV-1, which is a camera mainly designed for vlogging. That's a very interesting product for those who need something easy to use to create vlogs with. But one of the big downsides is that it has a fixed lens, so it kinda limits your creative possibilities. The latest rumors talk about a soon-to-be-launched ZV camera with an E-mount, so with interchangeable lenses, and it will come at $899. Let's keep an eye on that, as it can be an interesting product for those that already have a Sony kit and need a second or third camera to film some run-and-gun vlogs. The other rumor of the week comes from Sony Alpha Rumors, who has received the first leaked images of the new Sony 28mm f1.8G lens. It should be launched within the next 2 months and is gonna be very interesting for street photographers. In fact, 28mm is a particular focal length, as it's wider than the typical 35mm or 50mm, so it includes more elements in your shots. It has less bokeh, and it forces you to get closer to your subject. This all translates into having to go outside of your comfort zone and expand your creativity, which is something that we should all be doing. So that's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. What's the news that you like the most? Just let me know in the comments below. And remember, the giveaway where you can win a $500 carbon fiber tripod closes this week. So if you haven't already, make sure to enter by clicking the link in the description. If you've liked this video, please give it a big thumb up. And if you found it useful, I would appreciate it if you could share it with your photography friends. And if you need any help with your photography, please feel free to reach out. You can DM me on Instagram at Alessandro_Carpentiero or via email at support@alessandrocarpentiero.com, and I will be happy to help. So that's really it for today. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.